Honorable Chair and Vice Chair and distinguished commissioners, in a hypothetical scenario when a private developer has violated the Coastal Act on state land and a state agency has also committed a violation and the state agency applies for a coastal development permit, the Coastal Commission should not accept reports on hydrology or methane or wetland delineation from the same private party that violated the Act as substantive documents. In such a case, staff should only consider a state wetland delineation and reports from the applying state agency as substantive. Such reports submitted by a state agency must use unconflicted contractors hired under state contract law to avoid conflicts of interest and to ensure such reports are unbiased. Staff should not accept as substantive reports from a private developer that is conflicted, biased, and who intends to conceal its crimes by such submissions. If staff claims such biased reports submitted by a conflicted violator are substantive, the state agency should validate that in writing. That is, if the state claims that the private conflicted violator submits reports on its behalf, the state should validate that in writing, if this is the case. For staff to knowingly refer to reports submitted violators who are conflicted in substitution of state-produced documents, that should be construed as misconduct, and this commission should not consider such documents as substantive. For instance, if a wetlands delineation is submitted to the Coastal Commission by a known violator attempting to conceal its crime, staff should not accept it. What staff should produce as a substantive document is a wetlands delineation by the state of California itself. In the Biona wetlands, the California Coastal Commission required a redelineation in approximately 1991 for Coastal Development Permit 591463. The Department of Fish and Wildlife did redelineate the wetlands, and the commission accepted that wetlands delineation. So it's only the state wetlands delineation that should be used for matters in the Biona wetlands, and certainly not a delineation by a violator actively trying to conceal its crime. I could not understand why staff would ever do such a thing, especially when it would come to any hypothetical methane or hydrology reports. In regard to Coastal Development Permit 591463, the applicant has deviated from its permit in several ways. It did not place the required deed restriction on the riparian corridor portion of the flood control project authorized by the permit. The permittee did not obtain a flood control permit from the County Department of Public Works Flood Control District as required by law prior to the application for the CDP or even thereafter. This has left the Playa Vista Project Phase 1 and Phase 2 with a coastal development permit that is for flood control purposes, but without a flood control permit. This should have been on deck in 91 with the application, and as a result, the public and infrastructure is placed in harm's way due to this mistake of the Coastal Commission in accepting the application without a flood control permit. This is a very important matter. We do have floods, and we are overdue for something called the Arc Storm, which occurred in about 1882, which flooded the state of California. It flooded the whole state. The Great Valley was flooded for 15 miles across, and I think it was at least 60 miles in length. And each and every community in the state had great flood problems. You can find this by looking for Arc Storm produced by the U.S. Geological Survey on YouTube. I have filed several complaints of fraud, of deviation from the coastal development permit, et cetera, against Playa Vista who was the applicant and permittee for this particular project. Additionally, I and others have filed complaints against the project for actively draining the aquifer beyond its historic levels in violation of the water code, hydrologically upgradient from the biennial wetlands, and preventing the recharge of the wetlands by disallowing the groundwater to flow down gradient to recharge the wetlands. The Playa Vista project is actively attempting to dry the wetlands out, and this is impermissible. And they're not allowed to draw down the aquifer, which is under the Porter Clone Act, a public drinking water, a potential public drinking water resources, and it should be preserved, and it should not be tossed into the sewer by a private entity. Thank you very much.